Today, guys, we are going to talk about how to apply correctly the defensive top row. Hey, it's Kyle from OmnipotentGrow.com. I'm here with my friend Tumbev. He's a fellow arm wrestler, a big champion. We are going to show you how to implement the defensive top row when you're against a really strong hooking person, which has a really tight and strong insights. So you want to be able to maneuver around him and not connect with his strongest points. So the way we are going to set up the grip is, again, we are starting from the pinky, and the angle now is not as before in the top right corner. Now the angle is in the bottom left corner when you're with right arm. So I'm connecting here, I'm setting up, and then I'm going to leverage with my elbow and try to be almost contracted before the start in that position. So when your opponent is starting to hook, then I go here into the contracted position, which we are training with the blue cable I showed you in the video about the defensive top row. So the idea is that now, if you see it here, I'm also putting pressure on the wrist with the side pressure, and I'm also bumping up his little finger and taking advantage of his grip. So he tries to hook, but now I'm in the back side. I'm all in my side. You see the grip is almost on my pad. So he can't finish the match. He can stop here with a straight wrist, but it's really difficult when my arm is here. It's really difficult to finish the match because I'm using my vectors, and it's like my arm is a lever, and I'm using my inner joints, my shoulder and my pronation, so I can get here, and he's not able to finish the match. So I stop it here, and when the time passes, you're trying to go into the side, into the side, into the side, and eventually his wrist will flop, and then from that point on, you want to be from that angle to go maneuver a bit into the middle. And now when you're into the middle, you can do the side pressure that we are training. It's around his arm. And now you're implementing all your strengths at once and try to finish the game. This is, again, really good to do in strap, but it's also harder in the strap. As I showed you before, when we have a strap here, when we have the strap now, it's easier for our opponent to connect with our arm because he has the two sides of the strap here, and it's easier to maneuver and to side press and to curl with the wrist. But we also have this here, which is our main tool that we want to use. So we do again with our fingers, starting with the pinky, and we try to put maximum pressure on this band here. So we are attacking by attacking the band itself. So we are using it to be intensely connected with our arm, and then we are trying to take the wrist of the opponent by moving aside, and then we go into the middle and try to finish it with a press. This is why it's really important always to train side pressure, because if you hold this dynamic hit with your pronation and with your defensive top row, you eventually will have to finish the game. It's not only about stopping the game, it's afterwards finishing it. So side pressure, really important to every style. So guys, this is it for today. I hope that you understand a little bit better how defensive top row works. We are going to show you how to train it with a partner for the future. Watch the other videos if you missed something. Subscribe to the channel and see you again soon.